Right.
Well, yeah. No, I don't want a subtle shift between you and your roommate, but also, like, people who think they're sneaky about smoking are idiots.
Yeah.
Everyone knows.
Yep.
Not if you cover yourself in banana boat so that's the only thing anyone can smell. That was the strategy of people I knew in college. The only time you smelled banana boat on that mountain was when you were next to someone who was trying to hide the fact that they smoke.
Where I went to college, we had a huge number of, because we had a sister school in China, so we had a huge number of Chinese exchange students, and almost all of them smoked. And it's also my least favorite thing. I love living in Chinatown. I love living here. The only thing I don't like about it is everyone smokes cigarettes. Because it's, like, very, very common in China to smoke cigarettes. They don't think anything of it. Make sure everyone that you're wearing your gear.
Yes, I removed my non-Ulu ninja set from my thing of stuff I can equip.
Yeah, it's, like, they used to literally just, like, hang out in front of the student housing where all of the Chinese students live, because there was, like, a special building for that program, and, like, block the entire sidewalk smoking.
My goodness. When I was younger, my mom
would everybody
film that. Like, if I ever ran into somebody that smoked, just to cough really loud, nonstop, to make them feel bad.
They won't feel bad.
Yeah, and now that I'm older, I'm like, Mom, why? Like,
they won't feel bad. In fact, they'll think you're being a fucking asshole.
And it is, honestly.
Because trust me, but they know that. Smokers know that secondhand smoke is bad for people. They know that smoking is bad. They just don't want you to fucking tell them not to.
It's highly addictive.
There's nothing you can say to someone who smokes cigarettes that's gonna make them go, oh, really?
Yeah.
Like, they weren't raised in a cave. They know that smoking's bad. They're just not gonna stop. That's why I always tell people I know who they're like, oh, I'm dating someone, but he smokes, but I'm hoping I can get him to quit and, like, break up with him immediately.
Yeah.
Or you just get comfortable with the smoking.
Yeah.
Just start smoking, and then it will bother you.
One of you is going to be unhappy.
Cover deer. Mistral song. Spiny plume. Slipstream. Move.
Yeah, I started to move it. I'm like, Spiny Plume's doing kind of good.
Cover deer. Miss Lips also. Grab Spiny. Slipstream.
No, fuck. Sorry. Probably better.
Move. Cover deer. Mistral sign. Spiny plume. Slipstream. Cover deer. Mistral song. Grab spiny mat. Slipstream. Mistral song. Move. Slipstream. Move.
She's low.
Slipstream. Slipstream. Provoke. Bro, hallowed. Bro, shirt. Reiku. Provoke. Reiku. Shirt. Bro. Fetters.
Crap, that would put me at like -50 DKP. Glad we're not a knee karma. Oh, you have insulted Rudolph.
Mistral song.
Hey, that was the first time for me walking past that rock.
What does DKP mean? Is it like
it's Dragon Kill Points.
Yeah, it's a system for distributing loot in games with much larger raid groups than this one.
It was because with 40 people in WoW, and even EverQuest, how many did WeatherDesk go up to? It was a ridiculous number. Clue. I never played. I know it was neither huge, but yeah, you had to manage a huge roster and limited loot, so you figured out who was most deserving of things by letting them bid with it. Yeah. People still use DKP.
It's a long, complicated thing.
Yeah. It's basically like points for showing up on time, points for being helpful, and the raid leader can penalize you for misbehaving.
Cover deer. Miss Lips also. Spiny plume. Slipstream. Move. Move. Mistral Song. Move. Slipstream. 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 Provoke, Pro, Hallowed, Pro, Shirk, Raku. Provoke, Raku. Shirk, Pro. Fetters.
The eruptions were outside of its hitbox.
Oh, the eruptions were too close?
Yeah, even though I was flipping on the other side, the eruptions were sticking out outside his hitbox on the other side.
Okay. Yeah, I have to be careful there, because, yeah, I'll be careful. My cast is turning me toward
you. Did your taxi drop you off in the wrong place?
What?
I'm kidding.
My cast, like, turns me towards my nail, and I think I'm not accounted for it. Hi, babe.
Cover deer. Mistral Slip song. Screen. Gravity Biome. Slipstream. Move. Move. Mistral Song. Move. Slipstream. Move. Slipstream. Slipstream.
That shift was during a fire phase. Left. That is the extent of my move.
Please try to get in the center. I don't know.
Provoke. Pro. Hello, sure. Pro. Great move. Provoke. Great move. Sure. Pro. Fetters.
There's one setup of the plumes on the spiny plume where it just decides, no, you want one of these satin plumes. You don't want this spiny plume.
Can I have a favor? Can me, Deer, or Durin set up, just mark our nails so that way on the enemy list they're numbered and I can just click the enemy list?
Yeah, so, like, you want me to throw a number 3 on mine?
Yeah.
Yeah.
If that's not, like, a pain in the ass, it's just, like, I'm sick and fucking tired of trying to hit the third nail and selecting Ifrit. But if I know that I'm clicking the third one from the enemy, I can just use the enemy.
Yeah, I can do that. I can probably target yours, too, since I played Taxi there at the beginning, if that would be helpful.
Yeah, I mean, if it's no skin off your back, then please.
We'll see. I don't think it will be, though.
I'll put mine on just a moment. If they're numbered, then I can just click through the enemy list, make it, like, much easier.
I'm just figuring out what archaea I want to put this on.
Oh, I'm just going to have it on a clicker.
I can't do that.
You're like, I can't click!
Yeah, I'm like, no.
I can put it on my limit break.
Like, I used to actually remove my, like, the actual buttons from my screen. Just have the hotkeys. I put it on N.
For number. N opens my crafting log. I'll also do N. Although I do use that button. It's a button I know. How about H. I don't use my fucking hunting book. Yeah, I actually do hit N, so I'm gonna use H.
Actually gone off and completed my hunting log for a few classes.
H is what I use is but hide, but it was not like I did H for hide, it was just that's where it wound up.
Hotbar 5. Oh yeah, I use B for return.
You can click, I mean like that it's my thing against click and don't. Search for a heart key on account of mine.
What do I have G as? Nothing, I guess. Let's do G.
For the money.
That's my trick attack button.
That's way too far away for me to put this thing as trick attack on it.
Right, but I've got the massive, you know, clog hopper hands or whatever. Like, that's... G is, like, one of my easy buttons. Like, my weird stuff that I don't do. Like, H is on stuff I don't use often. And N. Shit, B.
Cover deer. Miss Lips for soft. Spiny plume. Slipstream.
Timing to run out is just really tight, so for the first friction.
Cover deer. Miss Lips for soft. Grassy plume ad. Slipstream. move. Mistral Song. Move. Slipstream. 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 Provoke. Fro. Sure. Hello. Rake roll. Provoke. Rake move. Sure. Fro. Fetters.
Also, we were going
Searing
to
wind.
Mark the nails. So.
Yeah, we were going to mark the last nail to die.
Yeah, it's probably going to take me a couple times to, like, that's not part of the muscle memory yet. Sorry.
Oh, no, not with the number 4. With the 2 mark.
I was supposed to do the baiting.
Yeah.
Because I had the original one, and it goes on to you after.
So, what are we marking the last nail for?
So, there's 2 ways that you can use the 2 mark. You can mark the healer's position, or you can mark the last nail to die. It's just a matter of preference. So, let's figure out which one we want to do.
Well, I was going to suggest, and it sounds like that's the other method, is we always mark the Searing Wind position, because it's early, and it's, you know, you don't have to worry about it, and then the party just stands across from.
Yeah. So they go across from the. So in that position, With the two where it is now, we would have gone between A and B.
Yeah. But the fourth nail works, too. It's whichever one you're... I just wanted to make sure that that was the same approach.
Yeah. So, yeah, because the two marker will be straddling where the rhythm, and with the pattern that we're doing, we're starting in front of Ifrit from nail number three with our kill pattern.
So I should be putting the number two marker under my thing, under my nail? Because no, my nail's long.
Well, how do we want to do it? Do we want to do it with the healer, or do we want to do it with the last nail to die? What's it easier with for you, Riker, to position to?
Whatever's going to give us more consistency, honestly.
I think probably having a mark under the healers. They have more time.
Like, as long as I can see where it is quickly, I know where to pull them. But if we're fumbling around with it, then I'm just going to go southwest and everybody can deal with it.
I mean... Okay. I mean, if we're talking time, there's a huge amount of time between the first nail... The last nail goes down and it dies. I don't know what the healer times are like.
We have it macroed, and as soon as we get the steering wheel, we put it down.
Well, okay, yeah, that'll be quicker.
Yeah. Okay. Alright, then let's just do that. And while we're starting, I can call where the part
is. And both healers have that macro? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they both do. They talked about it on the first day.
Okay.
Oh, nice.
We've been doing it.
So basically, we'll go to the inner card that's across from the two.
And then the healer who does not have searing is doing the bait with you.
Yep.
But do you want the healer with searing the first time to just call out between like A and B or whatever?
That's what I was saying. It's, you know, I'll just call out where we're going to drag. Wants to do it,
or I... Well, now that I know what to look for, I'm not super, super concerned.
Yeah. Well, I just mean for the rest of the party.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, Raikou's going to be in this. When you say drag the boss, he's dragging the boss to the safe spot, right?
Yeah.
So we just kind of follow big, giant boss. Yeah.
Just remember there's a... There's a cross-shaped dash going out, so you might need to hug Ifrit's butt a little more than normal.
Yeah, we have to be in the inner card. This is a big cross-shaped thing. And then there's a second searing wind that goes out, so the first healer will scoot clockwise, and then the other healer will go around counterclockwise.
For the cross-charge, I don't even think it's possible for you to be on his rear. I think you have to be in front of him, right?
I don't know. I haven't been paying attention how big they are.
That's just
probably
because...
the safe bet.
Yeah, but what you're
I think you can be on his butt as long as you're also, like, kind of in his hitbox, because I don't remember our Dragoon losing uptime there. Our Dragoon at the time was Alice and would have let me know.
I'm sure you can get the positionals in a hitbox.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Like, you can get the back positional if you're, like, inside the middle of this hitbox.
But, so basically what happens there is Raikou back at the inner panel that cross two marker. He will do a giant cross mechanic. As soon as the two players with bait come to meet up with us. So the two players with bait, you're going to be starting... just slightly outside of the two, to the point where you can get hit with searing wind. If you want, if it's easier, I remember in summer group, they started... so if you imagine that the party's at and the searing wind healer is at 6 o'clock, they started, like, in the center, and then they went out to, like, 4 o'clock, and then went up. But it's whatever you guys find is easiest.
We should move as soon as the damage goes out.
Yeah, as soon as the Hellfire goes out, you move. the only reason we stay stacked there is to make sure, you know, and then you just scoot right out to the edge.
Alright.
Yep. And that's as far as I'll explain right now.
If we get further than that, I'll explain.
Because really all that's left before dashes is Infernal Hell? Liquid Hell? I don't
Inferno
know.
Inferno Crush.
Thank you! Infernal Crush! That's all that's really left. Which is just a stack. Yeah, Liquid Hell. Liquid Hell is a move. But, triggering my PTSD.
Cover deer. Miss Lips Rizoff. Body cutting that. Slipstream. Mistral Song.
Oh crap.
Move. Slipstream.
Slipstream. Aerial Blast into Sisters melee, if you want to get positionals, that is cool, but please let me know ahead of time, because if you are on her rear, I am running straight there, and you drop feathers there. So
it was just me being slow on the going back in. It was not a conscious
decision. I'm just saying, if you guys need and or want to, by all means do it. Just let me know so I can run to the right instead of straight through her.
In situations where the Spiny dies like really early on top of Garuda, is it possible to pull her out a little bit, like outside of the bubble? Because like I'm afraid to use jumps there, because I don't know if it's gonna like trigger the.
Lines.
Yeah.
I can try. She's doing a lot of casting, so she may not be super cooperative.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, I'll keep an eye. I'll play it safe more than anything. Cause it's not like super killer. It's just. It hurts to sit on that jump.
As long as you get the first hit, you can just run it. And then... But it does take forever, I think, to move. So,
I think that's Brawl. That sounds like his typewriter.
Oh, it's his mic. I was just saying, it is his mic. Lighting up any type of thing.
Carl, what are you using for the spiny food?
Bulwark, convalescence, and rampart, I believe?
Yes.
Oh, just to aggro it, not the cooldown.
Oh, I'm shield lobbing.
Would it be possible It's like a moon eclipse, something like that.
It's an AoE attack?
It's a
total
AoE
eclipse?
Attack.
Yeah.
Apparently, because I was talking to Des about it, he was saying that it's possible for you to hit the Spidey Plume along with Garuda and along with the other feathers with the eclipse, and you get aggro with it.
Yeah.
So I'm not.
I mean, I could do it.
Sure.
It's just even less uptime for me, which it's already abysmal, so.
No, she's saying that it will not keep you from losing uptime, and you get DPS from AoE the feathers.
I don't think the range is right for that.
Sure.
I would have to leave max melee range.
Are you saying that you want him to wait until all the plumes are together and then throw out the first AoE?
Yes.
No, I can't do that.
Yes.
It always gets hit before they move together.
Well, we'll ask Des after the next one.
Yeah.
I literally threw something at him, and he didn't say anything! Okay. So, Gaga.
I mean, Des's name is Worse Paladin.
Cover deer. Miss Lipstrom.
I'm so fast.
Spiny Plume at Slipstream.
Are we gonna have the DPS taken down?
Home gang. Great move. Move.
Yeah, no, I saw the positioning. That would have been caught by a double.
Riku, you're not wearing your shiny armor.
I've never worn it to Uwu.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I forget that you guys don't apply your lands to your... I know,
Korn,
I see you.
Yeah, that's the tier one.
Mine is completely intentional so that I know I have the right set on.
Ah. Mine is intentional because this is the best in slot when these fights originally came out.
Cover deer. Mistral saw. Spiny Plumehead. Slipstream. Move. Mistral Song. Move. Slipstream. Move.
Michael, how you dying?
There's no healing.
Provoke. Throw.
My AC hit drill.
Slipstream.
Either healer, is there a place where, like, you would like a mana shift? Because I normally just mana shift you at the end of the phase, or if I see that you're really struggling.
What is the CD on mana shift?
120 seconds, 2 minutes.
So you get one per phase.
I could really use it, around, like, right after the...
Hardships?
It's, after the bubble, you know how she does, that really hard hit and the...
Burial Blast?
Yes.
Mistral Sounds?
That would be a really good spot for me if you give me...
Alright, I can mana shift you when I'm A-pocking into space. This one.
You said, like, a pool's a pool, so long as it's hitting at any point where it's not causing overflow.
Yeah.
I guess that's true. I'll just look for a good place.
That's usually the place where I know, like, I'm going to start getting into danger.
Danger!
I think I'm doing one too many shields, because I think they fall off.
Oh, you can always look.
Yeah. I've been trying to check it. He's left.
Cover deer. Miss Lips also. Grab Spine Man. Slipstream.
I wish it wasn't so slow to move.
Alright. Well, I was one of the people who entered. I will not do that next time.
Just like, I stare at it almost long enough to, like, burn two GCDs.
I might be wrong. Isn't the only thing that's popping is Frawls? If he goes
it
in
should
that
be.
Purple.
Yeah,
there's no other damage going out.
Yeah, so no. If
it's
the
just
feathered.
Has to wait, right?
Yeah, it's only. If, yeah.
I'll let you know how long until friction.
I think it's because, like, we're trying to heal after the, what's it called, the little AoE thing that she does, and because heals come out, like, from the radius outwards, I think Duran was, like, the first person from either Fluffy or I, so he's the last person to get the heal, so it didn't register by the time we're crawling in.
Respect the content and basically turn your bar to just Scorch.
cover deer. Mistral saw. Spiny plume. Slipstream.
My character model is going to face wherever he damn well pleases.
Move. Mistral song. Slipstream. Move.
I don't have any.
Slipstream.
Do we have no way to get him up?
No mana.
Slipstream.
Running to the wall.
Left.
Provoke. Pro. Shirk.
Break. What a shake.
The shield that went off.
I didn't use shake it off.
Oh, well then, what was shielding me?
I need a second.
I did a flip cap shield, but I don't think that was out of effect. Sick meme or attractive.
Actually, yeah, I need a bio.
back.
Welcome back.
Back. I see we're already practicing death. Good practice.
I was looking at, there's something that's been on my mind from one of these rounds, and it was how low one of my essential dignities hit right here, and it made me so sad that it was so low, even though his health was low, that I wanted to check the exact amount.
Cover deer. Mistral song. Grassy fine net. Slipstream. Move. Mistral song. Move.
I got it.
Slipstream. Slipstream. Slipstream.
Right.
Provoke. Bro. Hello. Regu. Provoke. Regu. Sure. Bro. Fetters. Deck.
I did it.
Yeah, right there. Good job.
Oh shit. Charges from inner cardinal to inner cardinal, the after the uncardinals, and vice versa. So basically, if woken ifrit's on a marker, we want to be on marker. And if woken ifrit's not on a marker, we don't want to be. And really, we should only really have to. We shouldn't have to move as much as we did. I think there was a little bit of panic on my part.
Oh god, we're actually doing this.
Yeah, so really, we start in front of Ifrit Numero, and then we move into the path that just got bulldozed. And then we can pretty much stay there. Unless he is on, you know, we have to move for the final marker, inner marker thing. But pretty much we should only have to move once.
Yes. So we just move into the path, which should put us at inner cardinals, and then you just have to keep running to a cardinal if Blue Ifrit was on a cardinal.
Well, you can't count on that, because with all the possible veil configurations, we could end up on a cardinal with moving into the path.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah, there's 16 possible nail configurations. So.
Okay.
Yeah. But up to that was good. We lived through, the thingy. Right, Coop?
Yeah, what's up?
Oh, I couldn't remember the name of that move. You were the one who said it last time. So.
Infernal Crush.
Thank you! We lived through that! Good job.
Infernal Crush.
Yeah.
It's like a stack.
Yeah, it's just a stack.
I feel basically, like I should wings there, but I guess so. Yeah.
No. Save your mitigation for Titan.
Alright.
It's a make sure everyone is still alive. Because if
Covered
everyone
here.
Isn't alive there, you can't do
anything. Mistral Song.
Yeah, you're gonna need everything for Titan. Ifrit's kind of a like, here's a DPS! Get ready to get your butt kicked by Titan phase.
Grimy Spiny Mad. Slipstream.
That was the configuration in which I swear to God the Spiny Plume does not want to be clicked. It's like the game's like, nope, nope, you're clicking nothing.
What is your question, dear?
Am I always going to bring this up with after? No, I'm going to be across from the two markers. So wherever the two marker is, I will be on the opposite arena, 180 degrees.
Cover deer. Mistral Song. Gravity Binding Net. Slipstream. move. Mistral Song. Move. Slipstream. Slipstream.
Damn.
Wahaha! 8.7K.
Don't lose focus.
Left.
Provoke. Pro. Hallowed. Sure. Reku. Provoke. Reku. Sure. Pro. Fetters. Stack.
In my experience, at least, the dash is snapshot, like, where you're standing really early, so you've really got to, like, be confident and move.
But seriously, though, I ended Garuda at 8.7k. That's, like, my new personal record.
So, healers, you guys should already be fairly familiar with this. But I need to be topped off as he's coming down because the Incinerate Trio is coming out immediately after, and Holmgang is not long enough to survive all three. So I have to eat the first one, and then Holmgang is next, too.
And is that the mechanic that happens right after that?
Yes. So immediately he's going to come down and face C. If you are at C, you're dead. Because that is a cleave, and it hurts like hell.
I don't know.
Well, I just, like I said, just need to be topped off going into when he jumps back down. So as soon as the Woken dashes are all going out, whether it's through a regen, a tetra, an essential, doesn't matter.
Closer to the center of the table.
Fluffy, your food, and John, your food fell off too.
You hit a moose, and the moose walks away into the cart wreck.
Yep. And you're likely dead.
What if you slide under a moose?
It won't be anything.
You drive some kind of clown car?
I drive a
clown car. No, moose are really tall. Are you yelling at
me? Cover gear. Miss Brawl song. Grimy Fumet. Slipstream.
I would say that. I think that's
it.
Thanks move. Mistral Song. Move. Slipstream. Slipstream. Slipstream.
Or DPS before, but if you can.
Sure, bro. Regu. Provoke. Regu. Sure. Bro. Fetters.
What?
She's come back from the grave to kill me.
It's spaghetti code.
Yeah, it's spaghetti code. Sorry, guys. I'll be more careful.
Oh, I see. Isn't that horrible for a moose? Like, shit, this heart is gonna break my knees.
I mean, it's more horrible for you if you die.
I would just hate being a moose.
Cover gear.
Oh.
Miss Lips also.
If you ever encounter a moose in the wild, they might charge you, but anything between you and the tiny birch sapling is so fucking dumb. Go, nope, can't get through that.
Grimy Flume Mad. Slipstream.
Yeah. You thought about me later.
Okay.
You're fine.
You're good. Go for it. Thank you.
Move.
I didn't get the second fortune.
You did. Wolf.
Wait, yeah. What?
No, it'd be fine.
Oh, okay.
Oh.
Oh,
wait.
That was the sound of me realizing that it had gone in too early, but then it turned out. Okay. No idea what sound it was.
It's the sound of Durin going, ah!
They sound like what I think a camel would sound like.
I keep talking to this woman at my park, John, who's really, really into her chickens. And I was like, you know who would love talking to you? John. She loves her chicken.
What breed does she have? Or breeds?
I'm not sure. But she is. The reason that she is selling the brand new chicken coop is that she wants to build them a custom that's also part shed.
Oh, yeah, custom is all the way to go.
Cover deer. Mistral saw. Body fighting that slipstream.
Somebody smacked the bloom first.
Why?
Move.
No, why did Fluffy rescue me when I was already on my way to the wall?
Because he's Fluffy.
Yeah.
I didn't think that was
you did.
Like this individual is displaying a pattern of behavior they have displayed in the past. I am highly confused by this.
Yeah, but the other day she tried to bring me eggs, but I wasn't there. She was like, I brought you some beautiful eggs. I'm so sorry. She wants me to come over and see her too.
Cover deer. Mistral song. Spiny Fume. Slipstream.
You know, point wherever you want.
Move. Mistral song. Slipstream. Move.
She's
Slipstream.
Did I not get that off? Like, I felt like that one was early.
Well, I mean, it doesn't matter because the provoke is just, you know, if she pulls from the tank who has it initially, it's not.
Wait, I pulled?
Yeah, no, that was on you.
No. Oh, no, I'm so sorry.
No, you didn't. No, you didn't. No, you didn't. No, you didn't.
Oh, I didn't?
There's literally no way you pulled off of me. You're fine.
Are you?
I don't know why he turned, because he had Frawl targeted as I was running back. But
yeah.
Just let's just provoke a GCD earlier.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna say. Is like I should probably just after the first GCD. After no, Hellfire.
Not the first, because I'm using.
So that would be one GCD earlier. It's.
Literally
1 second,
you can change your trigger.
It could have just been something fucky with the game.
Yeah.
Well, just for...
Well, just move it up a hair.
Consistency.
Yeah. Essentially. I could...
Because you're invoking right now on the 5th GCD. Just
wait,
make it
are
a 4th.
Huh?
You. Are you streaming?
Yeah. Use my profile on Discord. It says that I'd be streaming.
Yeah. Oh, yeah,
oh
watch.
God. I always forget that you play on a fucking super wide and I can't see anything. Your party list is like the size of an ant. Party list for ants!
I mean,
looks like we're in a movie.
Ultimately gonna do this. Not tonight.
I've been making ultimate puns for all of our runs.
But it's also really not important right now. But,
Sorry, alright, let's get
back. Just provoke a GCD earlier, bro.
I will.
You didn't. You did not take aggro, I promise you. There's no way in hell. That was a waste of
ammo.
Cover deer. Mistral song. Bunny Plume. Slipstream. Move.
I didn't
15 feet.
I mean, there's no way we can surround this door. As much as I believe in you, Fluffy.
Cut you for a ball.
I gotta make sure nobody's like alt tab, like some people are want to do.
Man, if y'all are alt tabbing after a death, I'm disappointed.
Alice was constantly
free. Cover deer. Mistral song. Slipstream. Move.
He had three, we all would have died.
I saw the little three on him. Oh, it might have been Fluffy's thing.
It was probably confession specs.
Yeah, that's what it was.
They look if you have three and cleanse it, it's 99999.
Cover deer. Mistral saw. Grubiny plume. Slipstream. Mistral song. Move.
Killer's
slipstream. Move. Slipstream. Slipstream. Death.
Wow.
Tank busters coming out. Home gang.
Home gang. Reku.
I got babies.
Yeah, we did babies. But look at all these alive people!
Stack.
I'm gonna die. But at least I died alone. You owe me too.
That was Enrage.
Yeah, that was.
Oh! Huzzah! We saw Enrage! Yes, I didn't remember.
So
that was 15% left.
Yeah, until the deaths, I think we were on track for damage. We were at like 28.
How are we gonna bait that last set?
Oh, the last set of eruptions,
You cut out.
Normally, the last set of eruptions, people just bait up the sides.
So it'll be wings.
Yeah,
really?
Yeah, if Deer and Betty could do it, just because Betty's slightly more mobile.
I mean, in the event that happens, we can just spin around him. That's all I did.
And I'm assuming that we're baiting it, like, let's say they're facing A, and Deer and I are baiting, like,
he'll always drop back down facing C, so if you're gonna pick a spot to bait, I would go bait at A, and we'll just move him more south.
Yeah, you mean like just towards his ass, right? We're baiting to the butt side. I'm not saying like in melee range, but whatever he's not facing, right?
Right. He's always going to be facing C. So where I am right now.
Okay.
So that incinerate combo will go out, and then once I can be mobile again, I can just start moving in slowly south to give you a bit more room.
All right, let's see.
You can either do it together, or you can each do one side. It doesn't matter.
Oh, I don't know what I was waiting for.
She got a balance. That's what you were waiting for.
Yeah, let's go with that.
I've had a balance.
Alright, focus up, guys. Last one.
Cover deer. Mistral song. Spiny Fume. Slipstream. Move. Mistral song. Move. Slipstream. 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 Provoke, pro, shirk, regu, hallowed, pro. Provoke, regu, shirk, pro. Fetters.
done.
Stack.
And the puddles were just a hair close to us. Come and get me! Go, Cork, go! No! But hey, we got some really good frog tonight.
So anyway, earlier,
Home Gang, Reku,
which remind me of this video on goat breeding I saw, where apparently the goat breeders, the female goats will start coming into heat before they are of an age where the goat breeders will typically want to breed them, and so they will go through like a whole cycle where they're in heat, like a whole year when they come into their heat, and then. But they're not allowed to breathe, so they just run around wagging their tails and making bleating noises, like running up to the enclosure with the male goats in it, but not being allowed in. So there you go. I just you mentioned that. It was a thought I was holding on to. I didn't want to interrupt Raid for it, so, you know.
Yeah, I was talking to Sam earlier, and she was like, you know... John's the only one who will talk to me about goat husbandry.
Like, yeah, we stayed up to like 3 a.m. talking about goats or whatever after Jeff's karaoke thing.